think sex is enough to keep a relationship together?
Oh my god, sex is so important in a relationship. Yes. Normally when I get to know someone and I really like them, I'm not gonna have sex with them. Like, if they're bad or something, I will take it into consideration. I mean, I think you can always teach a guy how to be better. But if that doesn't work and sex is really important to you, then no, it's not gonna work out.
So would you say you have good...
Wait a minute. Hey, hold on. I've reacted to a lot of clips from this man. I've never heard him be that frontish. My man came out with it. Do you think you have good coochie? Let's see what she say.
Bye. I can't answer that. That is confidential. Confidential information.
Is it good enough to keep a man with nothing else?
No, because guys will fuck anyone. So it doesn't matter if you have good coochie or not.
So what else would you need to do to keep a man in a relationship?
You know, I've been with a lot of men. No, dated men. And I still haven't figured it out. I don't know what keeps a man. You can be the hottest person ever. You can be the smartest girl ever. You can have the most money. And it never keeps a man.
How y'all feel about that answer? I actually like those answers. I like those answers. Let's double back. If some of y'all running around here think you got that good coochie, and you don't. It's a lot of y'all out here, pillow princesses, and you don't know how to create an experience. Good coochie is about an experience. A lot of y'all miss the point of that. You think because you walking around with it, that's it. No, that's not it. That's not it. Get off your back.
Ooh, you forgot to turn that location off, honey. Forgot to turn that location off, didn't you?
No.
You forgot to turn that location off.
No.
Oh, you forgot to turn that location off. No, who is this? I don't follow you. We share location. I don't follow you. We share location. We share location. You ain't got nothing for me. You ain't got nothing for me.
Hold on, bro. I got something for you. Sound like a threat, bro. I never understand people who just be out here threatening folks, especially on camera. Like, you can't just threaten folks. Think about it this way, right? You threaten somebody, now something happened to them. Even if you had nothing to do with it, guess who the prime suspect?
Yeah, I do.
I brought you to get your nails done. But you ain't had no being a follower.
Don't put your camera in my face.
That's your girl.
Then leave, bro. Turn that location off if you don't want to be followed. Turn that location off.
Call me when you get to the house.
I'm not calling you. Thank you for getting my nails done. I'm not calling you.
So you just gonna take my...
No.
So you just gonna get your nails done and run?
Yeah, that's what I'm about to do.
Okay.
You got to...
Y'all, look like some clowns out here. That, both of y'all look like some clowns.
I look like a clown.
Both of y'all look like some clowns.
Girl. My nails are done.
Okay.
My nails are done.
Okay.
Get yours done.
Mine done.
Get yours done.
Girl, clown.
I ain't gonna lie, OG mad as hell she blocked on that situation. He done got them nails done. He thought he was finna tear some cheeks up. Fellas. Especially old fellas, man. When you young, we know you make mistakes and you know you might step out on your girl or something like that. And that's not cool too, but it's excusable when you're young. But god damn, when you pushing 40, pushing 50, grow up, dog. You running around here playing hide and go seek, man. You too old for that. You might catch a heart attack.
Should OnlyFans females be taken serious?
Don't have OnlyFans. I am stripper.
You're a stripper?
Yeah, of course.
You like being dominated? Of
course. Yeah, of course. I like money too much.
You like men like choking you?
I like black men.
Okay,
that's
do you
favorite.
Hey look, do you like eating? Let's be real.
Where that came from?
Analysis. Maria.
Maria, yo me llamo Roberto. Maria.
Okay.
You only like black men, that's it?
I like it.
No más black men?
No más.
No Mexican?
Me gustan trigreñitos así como tú.
Sí.
No me gustan los blancos, es la verdad.
I like girls with curly hair.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Qué casualidad.
¿Verdad?
Casualidad.
Should
OnlyFans females be...
These them Spanish girls you gotta leave alone. Them bubbly, cute personality. And she look good. Yeah, leave her alone. I keep telling y'all, I ain't never seen nobody get in a relationship with no Spanish girl and leave that relationship still the same person. These be going through, what you call it when you go to war? These be shell-shocked. I feel as though these Latin women need to walk around with a sign. They need to walk around with a warning label to put it on the drawers. This come with post-traumatic stress. I know it's about 25,000 of you guys that watch these videos that still haven't subscribed. Hit that subscribe button. Come on now, we almost at 100K, man. We almost at 100K. And follow me on the gram. Follow me on Instagram. Let's do this.
Who the f-
Steven, no.
Who the f- is he?
Steven, no. Hold on, bro. This man gets caught in Steven's house, banging Steven's woman, and has the audacity to tell Steven to watch his tone. Oh, man.
Stop.
What
the f*** you doing here, bro?
Stop.
Bro, you got him in my...
I'm sorry.
Watch your tone. He said it again.
Hey, bro. Bro, can you please leave, bro?
Oh, he beating Steven ass.
You knocked my boyfriend out. Oh my god. Why would you knock him out? He's obviously upset. Steven, are you okay? Oh my god, get out. Get out!
Man said, I'm a gangster.
Get out! Don't ever cross me again! Steven, are you okay? Steven, get out! Steven, oh my god, I'm so sorry. It's not what it looked like. I'm so sorry.
What the f*** you mean it's not what it looked like? What does she mean by that? Bro, of all the videos I've watched over the past year, I think this one has pissed me off the most. This man walks in the house, catches somebody sleeping with his girl, and gets knocked out. He got knocked out. If he walked in there guns blazing, we would say he was a simp because he killed the motherfucker over some He'd have went to jail and sat down because he killed the motherfucker over some Y'all be putting us in the most compromising situation. Situations y'all be putting us in, bro. This man damn near almost lost his life for coming home. And you in there fucking up your co-worker. She in there fucking her co-worker, bro.
Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you like that. Oh, you're super wary, huh? You're like, who the f*** is this guy?
No.
Hi, guys. I'm Tristan. I'm sorry. I saw you from behind. I wanted to see if you were as beautiful in the front.
Woo!
What's your name? Nice to meet you, beautiful.
Woo! Yo! That is diabolical. Woo! I saw you from behind. I wanted to see if you were beautiful in the front. That was edgy.
Where are you guys from?
Orlando.
Orlando, Georgia.
Atlanta.
Oh, nice. Cool. Welcome to town. We're glad to have you guys.
Atlanta.
How long are you in town for?
Till Monday.
Till Monday?
Yeah.
You got any big plans for the weekend?
Yeah. Today's my birthday.
It's your birthday?
Yes.
How old are you turning? 22 or 23?
39,
baby. No, you're cabin. You're cabin. There's no way. There's no way. Yeah. What's your ethnic background?
I'm Mexican.
You're Mexican?
Yeah.
For real?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Damn. I like that. What's y'all plans for tonight?
I don't want to sound like a hater, but what y'all think? Y'all think that's a BBL? Fellas, what y'all think going on back there? Huh? You think it was manufactured? Do you think the ass come with a serial number? I'm just asking. It looked good. It looked good, though.
We're trying to turn up. Like, we're just trying to get sexy somewhere. So we can just, you know, sit back.
Okay.
Enjoy ourselves. Enjoy the view. Enjoy the music. Good entertainment. Good drinks, of course.
Okay. Cool. Here, I got people out here that handle concierge and all that, so. Yeah, let's get connected. Here, use WhatsApp? Y'all got WhatsApp up? Or iMessage, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see that. What's y'all vibe? What y'all want tonight? Somewhere there. Okay. Alright, y'all heard of Quentin?
No.
I'll take care of you, alright? I'll take care of you. Cool. It's
yep.
Nice to meet you, beautiful.
Alright, two things I want to say. So in the comment section, folks were saying that the black girls looked like they was upset. But I don't think so. I just feel as though they was minding their business and they had that resting face. Y'all, if you haven't seen the videos where I was talking about resting bitch face, you gotta go back. I uploaded that like last week. I follow this man on Instagram and all his clips come up of him talking to different women. And this man knows how to code switch. When he was speaking to her, a little bit of his urban came out. It wasn't too hood, it wasn't too much, but it came out. He wasn't as sweet and he wasn't as bubbly as he usually is when he's talking to them Hispanic women. I see you out there, Tristan. I see you now.
Situations where there's a wife and there's a side chick. To me, it's a very toxic situation. It would be better if we were to practice polygyny. More women would have husbands and there would be less competition. And women would live in sisterhood. They would love each other and care for each other and care for children. Children would have more mothers. Imagine that type of impact on our community when our people have more mothering situations where there's a...
I don't know what video I clicked on. I don't know if this is the Lord sending me a message. But you know, Lord. I don't know, bro. I'm going to be honest with you. Dealing with one woman is a task in itself. Now, I'm not saying it's a bad task, of course, you know, because it's definitely, the good definitely outweighs the bad. But I don't know if I'd be able to deal with two women, bro.
His legal name is Kenneth Dwayne Westbrook, but somewhere along the line, this 29-year-old Houston resident gave himself the nickname Boss Man Boozy. And this boss man liked Jeeps. Ken posted opportunities on Instagram asking people to rent him Jeeps on the car rental app Turo. You rent the Jeep, deliver it to Ken, and get paid up to $5,000 via Cash App. Seems like easy money, right? The problem is that Ken was not returning the Jeeps to the owners. Instead, he sold them to Mexican drug cartels and kept the money. This left the Turo renters with a real problem on their hands. Ken was able to do this 25 times, stealing Jeeps with a value exceeding $1 million. Fortunately, he left quite a paper trail behind on Instagram, Cash App, and text messages. When Turo called the renters, many of them stuck to the story Ken provided them and said that the Jeeps were stolen. But after the case was turned over to the FBI, the renters told the truth and provided the FBI with the text conversations between them and Boss Man Boozy in exchange for not being criminally charged. The FBI investigation culminated in the issuance of a federal arrest warrant for wire fraud, and Boss Man Boozy was arrested by the FBI.
Oh, he doing
his statutory maximum penalty is 20 years in prison, and since he has a rap sheet a mile long, the Boss Man will probably be going to prison for the better part of that maximum. And that's how it happened. happened. Follow me for daily crime stories. Have a great day.
What this remind me of is the people on Instagram and Facebook that be trying to get motherfuckers to use their Cash App to scam. Or they be trying to get somebody to go start a bank account so they can scam. Do not allow people to put fake checks in your account. I knew people that was doing this for years. It's like the oldest scam in the book. The thing about that is, once they post that fake check in your account and the bank come, they coming for you. They not coming for them, they coming for you. Now, there's two things you can do. You can either snitch or pay that money back. Your boy put $10,000 in your account. He takes six, he give you four. When the bank come for the rest of that $6,000, they coming for you. You gonna have to pay that back. You feel me? And they gonna bring the boys. So you looking at getting charged for $6,000. $6,000 is not a lot of money, bro. It's not worth it. I'll never knock nobody hustle. But if you gonna be out here scamming, use that money so you don't have to do nothing illegal anymore. When I was doing certain things, you feel me? I ain't gonna say what I was doing, but if I can go back to when I was doing certain things, I'd have bought a cleaning company. I'd be giving young boys the advice now. I'd be like, hey, bro, you and your peoples, y'all can put money together and buy a cleaning company. They got companies out here that they give you the contracts. They gonna find places for you. So now, y'all going to work, but it's y'all business. You and your peoples own that business. You feel me? You and your three mans own that business. They giving y'all contracts for like $2,500 a month, $4,000 a month, sometimes $6,000 a month, bro. All y'all got to do is go clean these places. Now, if you get about three or four contracts, y'all eating. But everybody want to be a scammer. You know, everybody want to do the street shit.
So I got this truck driver here, lots of Zaxby's, blocking my way out over here. I asked him very politely to move his truck, and he said I'll have to wait till his break's over. He won't move his truck for me when he blocked the fuel island, and I actually bought fuel, so I don't understand why you can't move. Yeah, right here. I'm in the fuel island. I bought fuel over here, and I'm a customer over here, so you need to back up so I can get out. You can back up less than 5 miles an hour to prevent your clock from running. Here, give me your keys. I'll back it up for you. You're not? Okay. All right. So I got this truck.
I wonder if his energy would be the same if it was a man. At my job, y'all see my pants and all that, man. Y'all see I be dealing with truck drivers every day. And so far, man, all the truck drivers I've dealt with are pretty cool. You know, at least on my side, they're pretty cool. But on the other end, I've heard some stories. And I'm not going to lie to you. My black ass do work in Hillbilly Central. And a lot of them truck drivers that come through there, boy, they look like they about two syllables away from saying the N-word.